All right, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. For those of you who are new, my name is Ahmad, and I'm a first-year medical student, and today I'm gonna be sharing exactly what's in this backpack. I use this backpack both for going to the hospital, and I just finished anatomy a couple weeks ago. I honestly have a lot of kind of funny slash embarrassing stories associated with a lot of this stuff in here. Let's just say this week was an interesting one for me, but I'm gonna get this big guy out of the way, probably contributing to a lot of the weight. It's just a hydro flask, you know how it is. Your boy stays thirsty. But this is the rest of the bag. Let's get into the good stuff here. This is my badge. I think y'all have seen it before. Honestly, I've been trying for a minute. That's the best I could do. But you gotta have that to get into the hospital, to get into the school. Am I giving you guys the secret to stealing my identity? Whatever. These are my AirPods over here. I don't know what number they are technically. Maybe y'all can tell me. I think they're the AirPods 2. When I'm doing my cardio and doing the flashcards at the gym at the same time, it's such a huge deal to have noise cancellation. So I don't know why I'm like acting like a salesman here. I'm not saying to buy them, but they're good for me. This is just my wallet. Not gonna open that, but oh, keys. The obvious stuff. Let's move on from that stuff quickly. This is pretty cool. This is a pager. All right, I just spent longer than I admit trying to get that into frame, only to realize that the reason you're not seeing anything is because I took the battery out. So it should be in here. And the reason I took the battery out is because I'm still new to it, and I don't want to accidentally put in some sort of nuclear launch code. So that's the battery. I'm probably gonna keep that out for everyone's safety. But they told us in an email, them being the administrators, to bring your pager to the hospital. And I've been wanting to use one forever, and I was so hyped. I'm like, I'm gonna be ready. I memorized everyone's code or whatever it is, their number, and I never got to use it. So I'm still waiting on that chance. But I wore it. I wore it and I felt so legit, but I did not do anything useful with it. Anyway, that's the first compartment down. Second compartment here. Ooh, this notepad, this has got some background to it. So let me show you what it is when I put this down. This is a notepad, not a notebook. So it's just made to scribble some notes on here, then rip it off and go on to the next one. I still saved all of mine and I'll tell you why. But first, I gotta give you some background. Basically, what is a week elective? A week elective is one where you shadow physicians in a certain specialty. So for me, I got plastic surgery and I was shadowing two different plastic surgeons. Two surgeons with very different styles. One was kind of new school learning, just kind of follow along, ask questions. One was very old school, and that's not a bad thing, it's just a different thing. And in his way, if he asks you a question and that topic had been brought up earlier, you better know the answer to it. And he's not afraid to tell you that you need to do better. So here are all my notes. Basically, the goal is don't forget anything that is taught to you in clinic. So I brought this, and during surgery too, but obviously you can't have a notepad with you when you're scrubbed in surgery. So you have to go outside right away, write down everything you learned, because if you learn something and this surgeon spends his time explaining something to you and you forget it, that's not gonna make him feel very good, and he's gonna let you know about it. So these are some of the ones that I didn't throw away. I basically throw them away once I copy them down into the real notebook. I don't know if y'all can actually see this, but you can see it's like super, super messy. And let me show you what I do when I transcribe the notes over. So I might have to blur some of this stuff. Obviously, none of it has identifying information anyway, not for me or for you. But for stuff that I'm not sure about, or if they're like specific cases, I'd rather err on the side of caution. But this stuff I shouldn't have to blur out, because these are just my background notes. Here's another thing about shadowing surgeons, is that sometimes they give you homework. And for example, we saw a patient with something called a gastrocnemius flap. It's just a specific type of musculocutaneous flap. And I didn't know much about it because I'm a first year and I'm an idiot and I don't know anything about plastic surgery. So I was asked a couple questions, I didn't know the answers, and he's like, all right, wrote down a list of things that I need to know for the next day. He's like, all right, come back with all this stuff memorized. So I did, and I wrote down, this is all just from one night, by the way. Let's see here. Yep, this is still stuff I can show you, but I do that homework for one night, and it's never brought up again. I'm like, bro. But in all seriousness, this was my first taste of something that older medical students I talk to complain about a lot, which is the worst thing is when you have a presentation ready because you were humiliated the day before because you didn't know something. You're told to make a presentation about it or research it, be ready to answer questions the next day, and you spend all this time doing it, you lose your night basically, and then it's never brought up again. But I guess this was my hazing. I'm not gonna complain because obviously the older students have it much worse. I'm just on an elective as a first year, so it's low stakes. But what I'm getting at is that this notebook and this notepad, great combination. Keep track of what you learned. You will probably thank yourself for it later, but what do I know? All right, let's move on and do some of the electronics next. Let's see what we have in here. Oh, wait, I opened the wrong one, but this is a belt. And this is not just for fun, believe it or not, there is a use for this. This is another thing that came in handy when I was in the hospital, because when I was switching from OR to the clinic, I wanted to have something to change into so I don't look like a bum on my first week. And oh, this is super wrinkled now, but there's a dress shirt. At one point I had a full suit that I packed in here super carefully, but I realized that that was way too extra. But when it's your first day ever, you don't know what anyone else is doing. This was legitimately my first week at the hospital. I'ma just come in prepared, and I don't wanna look like an idiot. I'd rather be over-prepared than under-prepared. Let me actually show you what else I had in my backpack. Yeah, I would freaking bring these two, like legit dress shoes and socks. I bet y'all are wondering how I fit everything in there. It was freaking humongous, but honestly, I think it was worth it the first day or two just to be extra prepared. I didn't keep bringing these shoes once I saw that it was too much. Instead, I brought these. Let me show you one second. I brought these shoes, which were comfortable to wear in the OR, but they also, you can kind of tell they're sneakers, but at the same time, they look passable. I'm not gonna say professional, but they don't look like Air Max 95s at least. The logo is not super prominent on them, so you can get away with those, I think. So yeah, there's not always tons of clothes in my backpack. I just wanted to be extra safe on that first week. But now we move into, let's do the electronics next. Actually, something, I keep on delaying the electronics, but something I want to bring up, because people always want to know whether or not I use my stethoscope. I don't know why. It's not in here because I don't know how to use it. I'm legit 2.5 months into medical school. Let me show you all I can do with it. Let me give you an honest example of what my pre-med stethoscope experience was like. So let's say someone comes in with a heart murmur. They'll be like, oh my God, you got to hear this murmur. It's super subtle though. Are you ready? I'm like, yeah, for sure. And I can't hear anything, but I'm not about to look dumb. So I'm like, oh yeah, yeah, the murmur. Oh, I hear that for sure. Maybe I'm exaggerating. Sometimes things were more clear than others, but all I'm trying to say is that now I do not use this as a medical student. I don't go up to patients and actually, I don't have that skill yet. That's all I'm trying to say. What I do use though, probably more than I should, is this iPad. Oh, I spoiled it for y'all, that's too bad, but I'm gonna pull it out in a second, so don't worry about it. This is an iPad Pro. I bought this right toward the beginning of anatomy, and it's been seriously nice to have. I'm still learning how to use it properly, but when I'm doing basic doctoring and I'm trying to talk to the patient while writing down his or her notes, it's actually super convenient because it's not as bulky as a laptop. You can carry it around easily and not feel like you have something weighing you down. People love to take notes on it. Honestly, sometimes it's a little bit of a flashcard machine because that's just what I was using it for at the time. But now that that's over, it's actually been very nice. I'm still, again, learning how to use it properly, so I'm not super qualified to speak on it yet, but I'm definitely getting there, and it's been a great, great purchase. Even though it is expensive, iPads honestly cost too much. That's just facts right there. And the Apple Pencil too is so nice. Drawing with that is really 10 out of 10. This guy though, if I only had to use this, it might be a little more difficult just because, I don't know, it's just a little clunky. You have to wait for it to load a lot. If you're going between patients, then it's gonna be pretty inconvenient. I love using my personal computer at home, but if I have to go somewhere, then I'm using the iPad more often than not. This is more for patient information and radiology and stuff like that. Stuff that you need like secure access for, and I can't use the iPad for that. So that's more of a necessity than anything else. All right, so the last thing here, this is gonna seem minor, but it's actually a very big deal, are all these freaking pens. Why do I have so many? Well, let me tell you, it's because I got roasted on my second day because I forgot a pen. So I had brought one the first day. I showed y'all I was taking notes, so that was good. But on the second day, I was doing the same strategy, had my notepad with me, and I would transfer everything onto the notebook afterwards. But I was sitting down transferring in these like 10 minutes I had of free time, but I left my pen when I was called to go to the next patient because, I don't know, it was just in the heat of the moment. It was stressful, all right? Anyway, I forget my pen. I go into the room. They're assessing the patient's improvement post carpal tunnel surgery, and they're testing their pain, numbness, all of that stuff. And of course you need to document that, like, oh, maybe 25% improvement in pain, 15% in the numbness. And they ask me for a pen so they can write it down. So I'm looking for it because it's like usually right over here, and I realize I don't have one. And as soon as the patient leaves, they're like, how could you not have a pen? Like, that's the most basic thing. I'm like, bro, you saw me with one earlier. Why you gotta do me like this? Ever since then, I had like 16 pens on me at all time. Got one in every pocket of my scrubs. I'm like, I'm gonna be like a peacock showing off all these pens. I got so many pens that are falling all over the place. But yeah, don't be like Ahmad. Bring your pens, be prepared, even if it's for one patient, because it'll be the patient you need a pen for. Honestly, this week was so freaking cool. It was the best experience. Like, being in the hospital was awesome. I was involved in way more things than I thought I could be, and I was really put to work, which I really appreciated. But at the same time, I was expecting it to be chill. Like, usually these electives are like, oh yeah, you go and learn about everything and it's fine. Like, I was supposed to shadow one physician, but as soon as one was done with their clinic, it's like, oh, this doctor has surgeries, you wanna follow her? I'm like, yeah, bet, of course. But they ended up being really long days. I'm rambling at this point, but like, today I went there at like 6 and I came back at like 5:45. And the worst part is, like, we started at 7, so I didn't have to be there at 6, but the doctor says he's gonna be there at like 6:20. So obviously you're not gonna show up at 7 if he's showing up at 6:20, and you always have to have a margin, and you don't know if you're gonna get lost. Like, you're still relatively new to everything. You don't know if traffic's gonna be bad. Anything could go wrong. So you have to have your margin. If you're not like 10, 20 minutes early, then what are you doing? So it's been long days. So you don't need any extra stress in your life. Bring your pens, bring your notes, bring whatever it is. Pro tips from me. This is the N95 mask. Obviously you have to have a mask on at all times. Not necessarily this one, it kind of depends on the situation. We didn't treat any patients who were positive for the virus, so that was not needed all the time, but it definitely was needed. And let's see, last things here are pretty chill. These glasses, you have to wear glasses in the OR. These aren't the glasses I wore in the OR though. These are just for anatomy lab. Charger, more pens. Pens for everyone. But yeah, this is essentially what I carry on me at all times. It's been a long day, so I'm sure I was rambling throughout a ton of this. Thank you guys so much for watching though. Click here or here for more videos. They're usually more organized, I promise. Just allow me this one time. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care and peace.